Okay, so here's the question of the day. How can you tell if a number is divisible by 7? There's many ways that you can tell if a number is divisible by 5 or 4 or 3 or 2 or 10 or whatever, but 7 is one of those numbers that's a little tricky. So I have a method here that I could show you, and we're going to find out today if 45,843 is divisible by 7. So the key is right here with this number, 546,231. 546,231. This is the whole key. You take the number that you're trying to find if it's divisible by 7, you take the number which we had, 45,843, and you line it up here. And again, you want to have this pattern, 546,231. Underneath it, you want to put the number that you're trying to find if it's divisible by 7. And you line everything up, the 3 and the 1, the 4 and the 3, the 8 and the 2, 6, 5, 4. If it was 145,000, then you put a 1 here. Let's say it was 11 million, then you'd have to put another 1 here. You have to continue on with this pattern, 5, 4, 6, 2, 3, 1. And the 1 would go here because it's 2, 3, 1, and you have a 1. But since we're not talking about 11 million, we're going to erase that number. I'll show you another example with a bigger number in a second. So we take this now, we line it up, and now we multiply. 3 times 1 is 3, 3 times 4 is 12, 8 times 2 is 16, 6 times 5 is 30, 4 times 4 is 16, and we add all these up. We add all these numbers up, and then we find what this comes out to. 16 and 30 is 46. 46 and 16 makes what? 62. 62 and 12 makes 74. 74 and 3 makes 77. So all this up adds up to 77. That means since these numbers here, 16 plus 30 plus 16 plus 12 plus 3 equals 77, and 77 is divisible by 7 because it goes in even 11 times, that means that this number here, 45,843, is divisible by 7 evenly. Okay, we got another example here. That last one might have been a little bit crazy to look at, so we're going to take a little smaller number, 343. Is 343 divisible by 7? Again, we line everything up, 2, 3, 1, 5, 4, 6, 2, 3, 1, so we put the 343 right here, and then we multiply. 3 times 1 is 3, 3 times 4 is 12, 2 times 3 is 6. Now we add everything up. 6 plus 3 is 9, and 9 and 12 makes 21. 7 goes evenly into 21 three times. So since 7 goes into 21, and you've gone through this method, that means 343, this is divisible by 7. Okay, we've got one last example here. 1,512,000. Is that number divisible by 7? Again, we use our reference 546,231. We line everything up. And since the 1, we got the 1 here, we have 1,512,000. That means we got to put a number up here. So we go back to this 1. We put it right here. We continue the same pattern. If there was another number here, we put a 3 here. If there was another one, we put a 2 here. But since we have 1,512,000, we're going to put a 1 here because the 1 pattern continues there. Now we're going to multiply, right? We're going to go 1 times 0 is 0, 3 times 0 is 0, 2 times 0 is 0, 6 times 2 is 12, 4 times 1 is 4, 5 times 5 is 25, 1 plus 1, 1 times 1, sorry, is 1. Now we got to add all this up. So we have 1 and 25 is 26, plus 4 is 30, and 30 and 12, if I'm not mistaken, makes 42, plus 0, plus 0, plus 0, still have 42. 42 goes evenly. If you divide it by 7, you get 6. That means since 7 goes into 42 evenly and you've gone through this method, that means this whole number here, 1,512,000, is divisible by 7.